to Eternal Easy Education. In this session, you are going to learn e-commerce chapter 15. Content of this video is evolution of e-commerce and the development and growth of e-commerce. Evolution of e-commerce. E-commerce is not a completely new type of commerce. The dawn of e-commerce started few decades, a decade means 10 years, a few decades ago, and continues to grow exponentially. It first emerged on private networks in 1970s. Electronic data interchange and teleshopping together paved the way for e-commerce. That means doing the commerce, commodity exchange, transactions, everything. The transactions for this commodity. It started in the year of 1970s with the private networks. As you know, network is a collection of computer or computer-related devices, and that is the electronic data interchange and teleshopping together form the e-commerce. Okay. The history of modern e-commerce is closely twisted together with the history of internet, because the growth of internet only paved the way for the growth of e-commerce. E-commerce became really possible when the internet was open to commercial use. This is the main point. Previously, the internet, that means the communication between the computers, are done with only private networks. Then it be in public for all other use, that is the commercial use. Online shopping started to grow when National Science Foundation opened the internet to public in the year 1991. Since business have reached websites. Here there is a column to explain this. It's very nice to learn. 1960s, electronic data interchange allows companies to carry out electronic transactions, a precursor to online shopping. That means the first way to online shopping. The English inventor Michael Aldrich connected a TV set to a computer with a telephone line and created teleshopping, that means shopping at a distance, in 1979. Then 1981, first business to business B2B transaction from Thomson Holidays. Then 1984, electronic mail. So this paved the way for the users to purchase items directly in 110 online merchants. Then in 91, National Science Foundation allows the internet to be used for commercial purpose. Then online retailer Netmarket makes the first rescue retail transaction on the web in the year 1994 August. In 94 October, Joe McCamley ran the first ever online banner ad. It went like on hardwire.com and promoted 7 art museum. Then in July 95, Amazon sold its first item, a science textbook, through online. Then in September, eBay sold its first item, a broken laser pointer. Then the first online shop, Zabas, in the year 1919. In 2005, social commerce, that the introduction of or the upcoming of social media is born thanks to networks like Facebook to have a social commerce, that is the e-commerce. Then Groupon is launched in 2008. In 2009, India's first e-commerce sale is $3.9 billion. See, in 2009, India was full-fledged of online shopping and e-commerce. With mobile commerce, it is expected to hike 265% up and will be $850 billion. But now we are in 2020, as of pandemic, now the e-commerce business is more than what they expected, because everything is done through online today. So this is the way how the e-commerce evolved from 1960s to 2018 as per now. Then what is the development and growth? So the development and growth have different way, different business strategies for success. So there is three. Here it is 1995 to 2004. In 1995, read-only web, text catalogs, forms, search, pictures, flash. These things are available in the internet. So the first wave of electronic commerce, dot-com companies or first wave are mostly American companies. So the first wave was done with American companies. So that websites are only in English language. Dot-com bubble had attracted huge investment to first wave companies. So what is dot-com bubble? You must know this. The dot-com bubble was a historic excessive growth of economy that occurred roughly between 1995 to 2000. That is dot-com bubble. It was also a period of extreme growth in the usage of adoption of internet. So that timing, all the traders tried to adapt to the electronic commerce methodology. In the late 95, there was a tremendous development in US equity investments in internet-based companies. So as we know, the investment based on these companies improved. And the composite index of US stock market rises from 1000 to 5000 points. So those who are listening news, they will be known of the points of census market. So here in this period, the index value of NASDAQ is 5000, more than 5000 points, from 1000 to 5000. As the internet was mere read-only web, the network technology was in its beginning stage, the bandwidth and network security very low. So it's a starting stage, so it was very low. Only EDI, electronic data interchange, and unstructured email remained as the mode of information exchange. Nowadays all the emails are interrupted, encrypted, many securities are there, but at the starting stage it was not that much secured. But the first wave companies enjoyed the first move advantage and customers were felt with no options. Then the second wave, 2004 to 2009, the second wave is the rebirth of e-commerce after the dot-com burst. So what is this? What does dot-com burst means? As we know, dot-com bubble is the hike in the investment of internet-based companies. Here, NASDAQ composite stock market index fell from 5000 to 1000. It is in reverse. This is infamously known as the dot-com crash. So the dot-com burst or the crash, this began on March 11, 2000 and lasted until October 9, 2002. During the crash, thousands of online shopping companies like Pets.com failed, shut down. Cisco lost a large portion of their markets, but Amazon also declined but recovered. So all the big or large online companies suffered a lot during this period, 2002-2002. So after 2004, it's a new rebirth. The second wave is considered as the global wave, with the sellers doing business in many countries and in many languages. language translation and currency conversions were focused. So many languages and currency conversions, which is record our time. Then the companies used their own internal funds and gradually expanded their e-commerce opportunities. As a result, e-commerce growth has slow and steady. It was slow, but even though it is very steady. Rapid development of network technologies and interactive web offered the consumers more choices of buying. That is the interactive web. First it was read only, now it becomes interactive. The increased web users nourished e-commerce companies during the second wave. That means the internet is now read and write, social commerce, blog, wikis. So many improvements are there in the internet. Then third wave. The third wave is brought on by the mobile technology. Because of the improvement in the mobile technology, all are going to use nowadays, all are having smartphone, button phone, that the default set has become out of station, out of fashion. It connects users for real time and on demand transaction via mobile technology. So previously we have to go for a browsing center, we need a computer to browse for anything, but now we are having a technology which is in our palm, which is in our hand, to browse and communicate with anyone. The term Web 3.0 summarizes the various characteristics of future internet. Future internet with include artificial intelligence and semantic web. Artificial intelligence in the sense, you may know if you are browsing for a particular brand 2 weeks before, after that there will be many suggestions for you regarding your taste of search. That is artificial intelligence. One of the feature of artificial intelligence that will communicate with you based on your search. There are many things behind the artificial intelligence. So the growth in technology improvised the e-commerce business in a tremendous way. So this is the development and growth of e-commerce. So you have learned two things. One is evaluation, what is the beginning or how it started, and what are the growth and development up to now in e-commerce. That's all for this session, children. Thank you. Have a good day.